Hello everyone, Adam here. As you asked, we are getting back to the microphone jamming or the microphone suppressing solution that will allow you to secure your own privacy by preventing from unauthorized voice recording. And you asked me to improve my design so it could have better efficiency in jamming. So I went to the page, to the original page of this project, to these guys, and tried to recreate their design with some slight modification so it wouldn't be so much expensive. And what I did is I actually put another board to the design. So if you have the previous design of mine, the one with the DigiSpark, you will have to buy another board, which is AD9833, the signal generator, which will be used to generate the wave that will drive the amplifier. And I have also prepared two revisions of this design, one that will work with the former DigiSpark, just to have this backwards compatibility, and the second that will actually work with any kind of Arduino that supports the SPI interface, so the one with the MOSI, SCK and chip select pins. So they are actually both working the same way. So the original design is available on this page, and what I did, I browsed through this source code to extract relevant information. Actually, the thing that was placed in my code was driving this signal generator with a proper way. And my project, of course, is available on this page. So it is right here. These are the schematics, and right here you have the source codes. Getting back to the source code, let me look for it. And if you look into the source code, I have two versions prepared. One is for the DigiSpark, and this is basically a copy of the library for the SPI bus and AD9833 driving. And at the end you have this portion of code that I have taken from the original design. So as you can see, I'm using square wave to drive the transducers, and the frequency is random between 24 and 26 kilohertz. And the same basically applies to the design that is based on Arduino Pro, Mini, Micro and other boards. So in this case we are using original SPI library and the same kind of the same portion of code to drive the transducers. What you can do, you can play with the with this part, which means that the square wave will be used to drive the transducers. You may change it to, for example, triangle or the sinusoidal wave. As you can see here, these are the options that you can choose from. And that's all. So getting back to the design, you have all the schematics here. And what about the parts that need to be bought to construct all of these? So I'm using this page, www.aliexpress.com. The transducers, they really need to be 25 kilohertz, so 40 kilohertz will not work. So you ask me many times and I answer for the 100th time, only 25 kilohertz are good. Okay, as you can see, you can buy 20 pieces for $15. The same applies to signal generator. Is also cheap, $3 for one board. It has to be the simplest one. Don't go into this one, simply buy this one. The same for power amplification module. You may use, of course, the better one, something that will give more power, like this one with the potentiometer on the board. This is also good. And DigiSpark or any other Arduino board that can drive the SPI bus is good. Okay, so let's now go to see how it works and how it is built when connected.
Okay, now the demo time. I'm using a spectrate application that will show you the waterfall display of an audio that is received by the microphones, and I'm using for demo two kind of phones. This is an expensive one. This is a Samsung S20 Plus, and this is Samsung it's J5, I believe. Okay, so what is the difference? This one, this cheapest has only single microphone here, and this more expensive has two microphones. This is one microphone, and this is second microphone. And when I press on, in 5 seconds it will start. You will see what is the difference between these two. Okay, as you can see, it generates a lot of noise from 50 Hz up to 5 kHz or maybe even 10 kHz. And it works better for this one because it's only single microphone based. When I make it like this, so the microphone would be from this side, it still works. But when I do it with this phone, as you can see, the efficiency deteriorates, so it's lower than before, because this device has kind of noise cancellation. So for these high-end phones, the transducers will have to be oriented exactly the way the microphone is placed. Okay, so this is why it should all be placed on some kind of spherical surface. For this, doesn't matter. As you can see, it works even when oriented in different ways. But for this, it is very sensitive to orientation of this transducer. Okay. Let's now test it with voice recording. Okay, I have two dictaphones prepared. One is on the expensive phone and second one is on the cheap phone. And now I will switch on and off this device and move these transducers in every direction to show you what is the efficiency of jamming. So let's get started. Now it is off. Now I'm switching this one on and I will be counting to 12, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 19, 20. And now I will replay, first on the expensive phone.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
Okay, as you saw, when I was moving these transducers, the efficiency was not so good. So they need to be pointed directly to the microphone. And now, what about the cheapest phone?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9...
As you saw, for the cheapest phone, even though I was not pointing directly the transducers into the microphone, the efficiency was really good. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. You can build it on your own. Please use the schematic I have given to you on the GitHub page. And if you like this video, please leave me a like and subscribe my channel for better new videos. Thank you very much. Bye bye.